Hello students, today we are discussing a concept of area of triangle of class 10th that is related to exercise 7.3. So first we have to understand the formula for solving these types of problems. Suppose this is a triangle ABC and the coordinate of each side, each vertex of a triangle, let A, B and C, and the vertex of A be x1 and y1, vertex of B be x2, y2 and vertex of C be x3, y3. So formula for area of triangle will be equal to, so in our previous class, that is class 9th, we have discussed area of triangle ABC is equal to half into base into height. And in 9th class, we have also discussed the area of triangle ABC is equal to Heron's formula. Hope you recall the formula, that is S minus A, S minus B and S minus C. So with the help of this Heron's formula, we are able to find the area of triangle, and with the help of half into base into height, this is also a formula for finding area of triangle. So in both the formula, we are not having vertices, we are not discussing about the coordinate. So here we are discussing about coordinates. So each and every point have some coordinate. So to find the area of a triangle having coordinates is half x1 y2 minus y3 plus x2 y3 minus y1 plus x3 y1 minus y2. How to learn this formula? You have to understand this. You have to write x1, x2, x3. You just have to understand this 1, 2 and 3 cycle. 1 to 2, 2 to 3 and 3 to 1. So first we have to write what? X1. So what after 1? That is 2 and 3. So Y2 minus Y3. So next what we have? X2. What after 2? 3 and 1. So Y3 minus Y1. Then last one is what? X3. What after 3? 1 and 2. So y1 minus y2. So this is the formula for finding area of triangle in the coordinate plane. You have to understand one more concept. If these three points are collinear, if points are collinear, then area of triangle ABC is equal to 0. How? If these three points are collinear, suppose this is A, this is B and this is C. If these three points are collinear, that means these points are not in closed surface. Therefore, they are not making any area, because we have to find out area of any field that is closed surface. So if the points are collinear, then the area of triangle will be 0. So this is the important concept to learn this exercise. So let us discuss first question of exercise 7.3. So there is only two concepts. First one is formula and second one is this. If points are collinear, that means their area is 0. First question is, find the area of triangle whose vertices are this, this and this. So here we are having three points A, B, C. So the coordinates of A will be 2 and 3. Let this is x1, this is y1, this is x2, this is y2 and this is x3 and this is y3. As we discuss in this formula, it is not necessary that you have to take these points in order, until unless it is not given in the question that you have to take these points in order. So here we are taking A, B, C, x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. According to formula, what we have, area of triangle will be equal to half x1, y2, minus y3 plus x2, y3, minus y1 plus x3, y1, minus y2. So half x1, according to formula, x1 is what? 2. So x1, y2 minus y3, what is y2? 0 minus, what is y3? Minus 4, 0 minus minus 4, plus x2, what is x2? That is minus 1, and y3 minus y1, what is y3? Minus 4, minus, what is y1? Minus 3, plus x3, that is 2, and y1 minus y2, y1 means 3, minus y2, where is y2? Here is y2, 3 minus 0. So 1 by 2, 2 into minus 0, minus into minus plus, 2 into 4, 2 into 4, minus 1, minus 4 minus 3 will be minus 7, plus 3 minus 0 will be 3, so 2 into 3. So 1 by 2, 2 into 4, 8, minus into minus plus, 7 into 1, 7, plus 3 into 2, 6. So 7 plus 8, 8 plus 7 plus 6 will be equal to 21. 21 upon 2 square unit. So area of triangle ABC is 21 by 2 square unit. Similarly, you have to very easy to solve this types of question. Similarly, there is one more question for you in homework. That means you have to find out the area of triangle whose vertices are minus 5 minus 1, 3 minus 5, 5 and 2. Do it by your own. Now we are discussing one more question. Find the value of k for which the points are collinear. We have to now this k, we have to find the value of k as it is already given that the points are collinear. So as we discussed previously that if the points are collinear then area of triangle will be 0. So area of triangle ABC is equal to 0. Again we are using same formula, half x1 y2 minus y3 plus x2 y3 minus y1 plus x3 y1 minus y2. So here we have x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. We just substitute the value of all this x1, y1, x2, y2 and x3, y3 coordinates as per the formula. So we get this while multiplying this and inside the bracket we get this equation. While solving this we get k is equal to 4. Very simple formula to solve you. And here is one more question for you to solve in homework, that is 8 1 k minus 4 2 minus 5. This is a, this is b and this is c. You again use the same formula, area of triangle will be equal to 0 and you have to find out the value of k for which these points are collinear. So do it by your own. Now this is one more question. Find the area of quadrilateral. Find the area of quadrilateral. Quadrilateral means four side figure whose vertices are taken in the order minus 4, minus 2, minus 3, minus 5, 3, minus 2, 2, 3. Now it is given that in the question area of quadrilateral we have to find out whose vertices are taken in order. That means you have to take this A, B, C and D in a proper sequence. You can't change the sequence otherwise you can't get proper answer. So let this A, B, C, D is a quadrilateral and this is A, then this is B, this is C, this is D. You can't do this A, B, C and D because you have to take in order. So these are the vertices are of a quadrilateral ABCD. Now what you have to do, you just have to do it by your own. I'm just giving you the simple logic how to solve this type of question. So area of quadrilateral whose vertices are this. So area of quadrilateral, let us join AC. You may join BD, it's up to you. So AC is a diagonal. When we join AC, here what we get, two triangle, one triangle is ABC and one triangle is ACD. So you initially area of quadrilateral ABCD, what we have to find, area of quadrilateral ABCD. Can we take this area of quadrilateral ABCD will be equal to area of triangle ABC plus area of triangle ACD. Area of triangle ABC plus area of triangle ACD. So what you do, you just take this triangle ABC. When you take this triangle ABC, it will become x1 y1 x2 y2 and this will x3 y3 and you just apply the same formula as we apply in the previous questions. What is that formula? Area of triangle will be equal to half x1 y2 minus y3 plus x2 y3 minus y1 plus x3 y1 minus y2. You just apply the same formula to find the area of triangle ABC and then again for area of triangle ACD you take this x1 y1, this will become x2 y2 and this will become x3 and y3. You just apply the same formula in ACD. Whatever the answer you get, you just add both the area of triangle, you will get the final area of quadrilateral ABC. So do it by your own using the same concept.